Whether you're an adventurer at heart, a dedicated planner, or a professional cartographer, the world is at your fingertips, literally. Imagine creating your own maps that tell a story, guide a journey, or reveal hidden patterns in the simplest way possible. Welcome, friends. Today, we're not just exploring maps, we're learning to make them. We bring you the ultimate guide to the top 5 free mapping tools of 2023. Stay tuned to transform your creative ideas into interactive, informative, and maybe even life-changing maps. From ancient mariners charting unknown oceans on parchment to modern adventurers using satellites and software, mapping has always been a reflection of our desire to understand, explore, and connect with our world. There are different mapping tools available, each with its own strengths and weaknesses. This list of the top 5 free mapping tools is a good place to start if you're new to mapping or if you're looking for a tool that can be used for a variety of use cases. However, it's important to note that no one tool is perfect for everyone. The best way to determine which tool is right for you is to try them out for yourself and see which one you prefer. It's also possible that you may need to use more than one tool to meet your needs. So first we're going to look at Google My Maps. So Google My Maps is a web-based mapping tool that allows you to create custom maps. It's easy to use and has a variety of features, including the ability to add markers, lines, polygons, and text. You can also change the style of your map and add a title and description. Built on the familiar Google Maps platform, it enables users to visualize and share their own stories, journeys, and spatial data in an intuitive manner. Google My Maps requires a web browser and an internet connection. Google My Maps is used by people of all ages and backgrounds, including students, travelers, teachers, business professionals, and hobbyists. Google My Maps can be used for a variety of purposes, such as creating maps for personal use, such as planning a vacation or tracking your progress on a fitness goal. Creating maps for educational use, such as marking historical sites or creating a map of the world's different biomes. You can also create maps for business use, such as mapping out a sales territory or tracking customer locations. The pros for Google My Maps includes its simple drag and drop interface, making map creation a breeze. The ability to add custom markers, routes, shapes, colors, and even photos or videos. Its seamless sharing options, allowing for collaborative editing or public and private viewing, and that it integrates well with other Google services and can be viewed on any device with Google Maps. Its cons are its limited advanced GIS functionalities compared to professional mapping tools, and that Google My Maps can sometimes lag when loaded with a significant amount of data. While offline editing isn't available, requiring an internet connection for map creation and editing. Google My Maps is free to use. However, if utilized within a business framework, or if there's a need for higher map view limits, it might be paired with Google Maps platform pricing. The second tool that we're going to look at is QGIS. So QGIS, also known as Quantum GIS, is an open source geographic information system, GIS software, that allows users to view, edit, and analyze geospatial data. As a versatile and powerful platform, it supports a variety of vector, raster, and database formats, making it a favored choice for professionals and enthusiasts alike. QGIS requires a desktop computer with a Windows, Mac, or Linux operating system. It also requires a moderate amount of RAM and disk space. QGIS is extensively used by geographers, urban planners, researchers, and any individuals or organizations needing comprehensive GIS functionalities without the price tag of commercial software. QGIS can be used for a variety of purposes, such as creating maps for scientific research, such as mapping the distribution of a plant species, or creating a map of land use change over time. It can also be used to create maps for government use, such as mapping zoning districts or creating a map of critical infrastructure. It could also be used for business use, such as mapping out a pipeline route or creating a map of customer demographics. The pros of QGIS include it being highly customizable with a plethora of plugins and extensions. It's cross-platform with it being available for Windows, macOS, Linux, and even Android. It supports numerous file formats and integrates with other GIS software, and its strong community support and regular updates thanks to its open source nature. The cons of QGIS include that it might appear complex for beginners due to its extensive features. Rendering large datasets can sometimes be time consuming, and while documentation exists, the learning curve might be steeper compared to more commercial GIS platforms. QGIS is entirely free, being open source. Users can download, modify, and distribute it without any associated costs. However, donations to the project are encouraged to support its continued development. Next, we have Google Earth Pro. So Google Earth Pro takes you on a virtual journey, enabling detailed exploration of our planet right from your desktop. With its immersive 3D imagery, users can fly through cities, dive into the ocean depths, or get a bird's eye view of the Earth's landscapes. Beyond exploration, it also offers tools for data visualization, site planning, and geographic information capture. Google Earth Pro is a desktop version of Google Earth that offers additional features, such as the ability to import and export data, measure distances and areas, and create custom presentations. Google Earth Pro requires a desktop computer with Windows, Mac, or Linux operating system. It also requires a moderate amount of RAM and disk space. Google Earth Pro is used by students, teachers, business professionals, and hobbyists alike. Google Earth Pro can be used for a variety of purposes, such as educational and research purposes, such as creating a virtual tour of historical sites or modeling the effects of climate change on specific regions, government and urban planning, visualizing city growth, mapping out transportation routes, or assessing disaster-prone areas. And it could also be used for in business endeavors like real estate, where one can showcase property location, neighborhood amenities, and even 3D building perspectives. You can also create interactive presentations that allow viewers to virtually fly from one location to another, making it a dynamic tool for storytelling. The pros of Google Earth Pro includes its stunning 3D visualizations, offering a near real-world experience, with features like the ability to import and export data, measure distances and areas, and create custom presentations, with the historical imagery letting users see landscape changes over time. It also allows for the creation of virtual tours and simulation. The cons of Google Earth Pro is that it requires a fairly powerful computer for optimal performance, especially in 3D mode. The vast amount of data can sometimes make it slow or laggy, and while it offers GIS capabilities, it may not replace a dedicated GIS software for specialized tasks. Google Earth Pro is free to use for both personal and professional purposes. There are no associated subscription fees, but there are usage policies to ensure fair and non-abusive consumption of their resources. So SWMaps is a mobile GIS and data collection application tailored for field mapping and data collection tasks. Designed primarily for Android devices, it's a handy tool for individuals needing to capture, catalog, and share spatial information. Right from their mobile devices. Users can record points, lines, polygons, photos, videos, and voice memos, making it an ideal choice for on-the-ground research and explorations. SWMaps is favored by environmentalists, geographers, travelers, and many who need an easy-to-use field mapping solution. SWMaps can be used for a variety of purposes, such as field data collection for environmental studies, like recording the locations of wildlife sightings or mapping out deforestation areas. You could use it to create maps for agricultural purposes, such as mapping crop patterns, irrigation systems, or soil types. And you could use it for assisting in urban planning by capturing on-site data for utilities, infrastructure, or traffic patterns. You can also use it to document during field trips, where travelers can mark points of interest, trails, or even campsite locations. The pros of SWMaps includes its intuitive user interface, tailored for mobile devices, the ability to capture various forms of data, including multimedia. It supports offline data collection, which is great for remote areas, and its seamless integration with Google Maps for the base map. The cons, including it being exclusive to Android, leaving iOS users out. While basic functionalities are free, some advanced features might come with a price, and it requires a small learning curve for non-technical users. SWMaps offers a free version with fundamental features. For advanced functionalities, there might be in-app purchases or premium versions at an additional cost. The last tool that we're going to look at is Mapbox Studio. So Mapbox Studio is a state-of-the-art platform for designing custom maps. With its powerful toolkit, users can style interactive maps, integrate vast datasets, and even use them in mobile and web applications. It's web-based, which means you can access it from any browser without the need for downloads. Mapbox Studio is cherished by designers, developers, GIS professionals, and businesses wanting to embed a unique mapping experience into their projects or platforms. Mapbox Studio can be used for a variety of purposes, such as designing custom maps for applications, websites, or digital platforms to enhance user experience with tailored cartographic styles. Visualizing data for analytics, be it for tracking a delivery fleet, mapping customer behavior, or even visualizing election results geographically. And integrating with mobile apps to provide location services, such as navigation, localized promotions, or user location-based content. It can also be used for producing print-ready maps for publications, presentations, or promotional materials, giving them a unique and branded appearance. The pros of Mapbox Studio included it being intuitive and a sleek interface with real-time map design feedback. It allows for customization of every map detail, from colors to font styles. It integrates seamlessly with other Mapbox tools and supports third-party data. And it has a vast library of data sources and templates to jumpstart the design process. The cons include, even though the basic design tools are straightforward, mastering the platform can be a bit challenging for beginners. Also, the free tier has limits, with extensive use or large datasets might needing a subscription. And it requires a good internet connection for smoother operation, given its web-based nature. The pricing of Mapbox Studio is free for starter tier with basic features and some limitations. For more extensive usage, data storage, or premium features, subscription plans are available based on usage and needs. Thank you for joining us on this mapping journey through the top free mapping tools of 2023. Whether you're a hobbyist, professional, or somewhere in between, the right tool can transform your mapping experience. Remember, maps are more than just diagrams. They're a way to tell stories, make decisions, and explore our world. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up, share with your friends, and consider subscribing for more content like this. Until next time, happy mapping.